the new and improved iBook Guide channel. In this episode, I've got four great tricks I want to show you that apply to the iBook G4. Some of these will work for the G3 as well, and I hope you enjoy. Okay, so the first trick I want to tell you about is a way to solve a crashing problem with the iBook G4, the 2005 model. This would be the 1.33 and 1.42 gigahertz models only. You'll know these particular models because they don't have a removable airport card. The airport card is attached to the motherboard, and it is the airport card that is often causing the problem. Believe it or not, the quickest and easiest way to solve the problem is just to remove the airport card. The problem is actually with the logic board, but it is part of the logic board that connects to the airport card. So if you take the airport card out, then the computer will stop crashing and it will run very stable. As long as you're okay resigning yourself to the fact this computer is never going to work on Wi-Fi again, and you can use it on Ethernet, then it should work fine for you.
I also suggest that you wrap the antenna cables in tape to keep them from causing a short.
Okay, so if you break the screen on your MacBook or iBook or Powerbook, there is another possibility besides repairing it that you might want to consider. You can literally remove the screen, and believe it or not, the computer will actually work just fine without the screen, just using an external monitor. Okay, so what if you want to be able to operate the iBook G4 with the screen closed? Now, normally you would not be able to do this because the computer would go to sleep, but there is a way to disable that feature by unplugging the read switch.
Here's what the switch looks like. You can follow the cord to see where it plugs into the logic board, and just unplug it.
So, just so you know, on this iBook G4, the read switch is here and the magnet is here. On some of the older iBook G4s, and especially the iBook G3s, it's backwards. The magnet is here, and you have to take the screen apart to find the read switch. However, there should be a wire running from the read switch down to the motherboard, so you could unplug it more or less the same way I'm showing you here. You just got to make sure you know where the wire is. I'm going to show you a better way to use a dual monitor setup on your iBook G4. You know, normally speaking, if you connect an external monitor to a G4 system, you only get a duplicate or a mirror image of the screen on the external monitor, which that doesn't really do you a lot of good unless you're wanting to run a projector or something like that. So how can you fix this problem?
You can download a free program called Screen Spanning Doctor. This program will allow you to unlock hidden features. Now you'll be able to use the external monitor like a second display, dragging applications over to it. Or perhaps you want to watch a movie in the second display while you work on the first one. Another problem is that by default, Apple will only allow you a maximum of 1024x768 on the external monitor. This program will also unlock all of the resolutions available, all the way up to full 1080p high definition. It will also enable the arrangement tab so that you can orient where you want your monitor to be located.
All right, well, I hope you found at least some of that information useful, and I hope you like the setup that I've got for the new channel. And I've got a great funny video I'm working on that you're really going to get a laugh out of. And, you know, it addresses an interesting question you never hear asked in the computer industry. You always hear people talk about how much better and faster and the graphics are so much better on these modern computers, but we never really stop to think about what we've lost. And what I mean by that is there are actually things that computers from the 1980s are actually better at than modern computers. And a lot of people don't realize what they are. And I've been compiling a list, and I'm going to show you in the next video.